deux derniers candidats. J'appelle d'abord Bimaram Kelawan. Bonjour Bima.
Bonjour.
Tout va bien?
Oui.
Bon. Donc Bima, vous êtes ingénieur?
Élève ingénieur.
Élève ingénieur à Polytech Lille.
Oui.
Vous faites du tennis de table?
Oui, comme amatrice.
Comme amatrice, d'accord. Vous aimez aussi la lecture? Beaucoup?
Oui. Ouais.
Toutes sortes de livres, à la fois scientifiques ou pas?
Oui, on peut dire ça. Mais ouais. Surtout, j'aime bien lire du Jane Austen.
Mm-hmm.
J'ai commencé à l'école et puis j'ai trop aimé et puis voilà.
D'accord. Bon, et ça nourrit aussi vos réflexions et votre travail plus d'études?
Oui.
Ou c'est vraiment la pause?
C'est la pause et puis je me dis peut-être un jour j'écrirai un livre, je sais pas.
Ouais.
En effet.
Très bien. Ben, Bima, on va vous écouter.
D'accord.
On vous écoute pendant 3 minutes.
Merci.
Bon courage.
Merci. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The other day, I was at the checkout point to pay for my groceries. And then I decided to swap my card instead of inserting it into the machine. But the fact is, when I swapped my card, the payment was rejected. And then I was baffled. Why was it rejected? So when I came back to myself, I inserted the credit card into the machine and entered my PIN code. The code was okay, so the transaction was right. Why on earth was the first transaction refused while the second one was accepted? The answer to this question is really obvious. The second transaction is an exclusive EMV transaction, where EMV stands for Europa, Mastercard and Visa. The first one not being an EMV transaction, it was refused. But how exactly does an EMV transaction work? When you insert your credit card into a machine, an application selection is done by the machine. The application which is selected can either be a MasterCard, a Visa, or a card bancaire if it's in France, because in France usually it's a card bancaire application which is selected. And afterwards, the main aspects of a transaction are defined. First, the cardholder's identity is to be checked either for PIN code or for signature. Then the data is checked for authenticity using either one of the three methods I'm going to state right now. Static, dynamic or combined, where static being the easiest way to check whether data is true and combined the most complicated. Then some records to be read is defined. Only then does the true payment transaction take place. The selected records are right. Then only you're asked to enter your PIN code, which you do, obviously. Then the terminal machine does a risk analysis based on three grounds. First, the amount to be paid. Second, the number of online transaction done in store, and third, the number of small and near misses during the transaction. Only then does the terminal decide whether to go online, then accept the payment, to accept the payment directly without going online, or to reject the transaction. From this we see that credit cards are complex but interesting means of payment. Thank you for your attention.
Why do you think it's important for people to know what happens when they pay with their credit card?
Well, the thing is, today, I'm sure everybody uses a credit card. I use my credit card, I always use my credit card, I never use money. But the thing is, I think it's important that we understand how it works, not just to use it like this, not knowing what's happening behind, enter the code and Today, we use computer every day, we use a mobile phone every day, we use credit card every day. I think it's important that we know how it works.
And to understand maybe when there are frauds, how can they happen?
A little bit. I don't master that subject totally. But yeah, a little bit. Okay. It's for this reason that we've started using EMV cards before it was a magnetic stripe card. So it was much easier to copy the sensitive information of a card and to make payments. So one of the reasons why we passed to EMV cards is to prevent frauds from doing illicit activities using credit cards.
Putting in your presentation, to talk about the magnetic tape.
Magnetic stripe cards.
Yeah, okay.
But because there are other sort.
There are other different kind of transactions with now the electronic
contactless payment.
Yes, and also by for instance by internet with this. Your presentation is only about the lecture of the magnetic tape and the card.
It's about what happens when we enter our credit card into the machine when the payment is made. When the machine reads the transaction being done. When I say online, the terminal, when I say terminal, I mean the machine. When the machine checks the transaction goes for an online because when online transaction, I meant that the machine calls the bank to ask, should we allow this transaction to occur or not? Because even in store, it can be an online transaction or an offline transaction. When it's an online transaction, it means that the terminal machine calls the bank and asks whether it should allow the transaction to take place or not. And an offline transaction is like the terminal accepts the payment directly, doesn't ask the bank or anything.
And is it working the same way with the no-contact credit card we have now?
Contactless?
Yes.
For contactless, the card owner's identity is not verified using PIN nor signature. It's a card holder verification with I don't remember the term actually. Thank you.
Thank you very much.